unang grupo para sa lakbay sa naisay, Buhay Madre!
Halina at magsimula na tayo!
Sister, to be a nun, it needed to pray many hours. Am I correct?
Yes, not many hours, 24 hours.
24 hours?
How can it be?
When or where you start your day?
It starts usually at 5 o'clock, waking up. Usually we wake up earlier to read or to reflect or to something. Say the rosary. 5:30, we are in the chapel as a group, as a community.
Even if the young sisters?
Yes, with the young sisters, yes. We have 1 hour prayer together, right? And we pray not in our name during the time. We pray in the name of the church. After that, we have breakfast. Each one of us very quick prepare the breakfast. Clean a bit the convent or cook something good, right? And then 7:15, we start coming.
You are here.
Right. We are up to usually 5 or 5:30.
So when will you resume the prayer in like a community?
5:30, we go to church in Pagalangan.
The side of Father Jonas,
where we have mass together.
Until when?
We stay there maybe at 6:45, right? By 7 o'clock we are here and we have another 3/4 of an hour day together. And this is the evening prayer and the night prayer.
But the mass at the Pagalangan and here is totally different. It is a mass.
Yes.
Is it every day, sister?
Every day, because there is also evening in the church, become part of the liturgy.
How can you do these things? Because it is quite difficult to pray, to help.
It's not. It's part of my life.
Is it part of your work to help the canteen?
Yes. When we started the canteen, it was not there. The canteen was not there. We started on the side. But then we noticed that for you Filipino, food is very, 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 very important.
Yes, very important.
To have a canteen running, it's not easy. One thing is this. From where I'm going to bring all the money? Usually to Anita. I give her more than 60,000, 70,000 every week.
Every week.
So if there will not be someone who try to economize, the canteen will go. You end up without zero profit.
Yeah. So how can you spend time with yourself, like buying what you want? Do you do that?
No, I don't do that.
you don't no. buy what you that want, go where you wherever you want.
Because then I did the vow, promise, in front of all the people, that I will promise to live in chastity, meaning I will have nothing to do with man. I will not get married.
One of your vow is nothing to do with money, with yourself.
Now, the other one is poverty. Poverty, nothing to do with money. Though, I have to do with money, but not for me. For others,
obedience.
Say about 12 years ago, 14 years ago, I was in Kenya, a very poor country, helping build there, right? Helping build there. All of a sudden, I went to Malta for holidays, but there's a very poor thing. Can you go to the Philippines? Here, there was nothing. We started with nothing, zero. Right? I used to come 3 or 4 times every week to start the school. And see you today.
It is
thanks to the Lord.
Pray
and
for you
thanks to the gift of prayer. Because without prayer, without the support of my sisters in the community, without the support of people who helped me, I won't.
Understand something.
I show you a picture.
I found it yesterday. I don't know how I found it. But this is 4 months before I entered religious life. Can you see her?
Who is that sister?
My sister and me.
Where is your sister?
Here. This is my sister. She's in America. Look at my shoes. It was the wedding of my brother, 4 months before I entered religious life.
Oh, 4 months before you entered the religious life?
Yeah.
This is you, sister?
Yeah.
Really?
Yes. You don't believe?
Yeah. This is a look-alike sister.
This is my brother.
Your
He's
family.
Getting old, yes. And this is me when I went last time to Malta with my brother. He's very sick at this time, you could see. This
sister,
one, my sister.
Your looks are different before and now.
But I am the same one. Anna Shum. Pray for us, I pray for you.
Sister.
All right?
Thank you very much.
Peace and good to quality
education.
Nandito naman tayo ngayon sa Divine Mercy Chapel, kung saan dito nagdadasal yung mga madre mula alas 5 na umaga hanggang alas 6. Bilang isang komunidad kung saan kasama yung mga young sisters. Dito naman ang kanilang kwarto kung saan sila nangungupisa. Kung saan sila nagsasabi ng kasalanan nila o nakikipagpintuhan ng seryosong usap sa mga kapwa nila madre. Sila natutulog, kumakain, nagpapahinga at nagdadasal. May chapel din sila sa loob. At dito magtatapos ang aming dokumentaryo tungkol sa buhay ng mga madre sa Mother Margarita de Princiat Catholic School. Hanggang sa muli, paalam!